When I was working out, it was freezing, but that was just all part of the training. Not looking at the time it took, I was so focused that you don't see the snow, you don't feel the pain.
Because of where he's come from, the Canadian system, it's very rare that you find a father who's that into his son.
I was willing to do whatever it takes to get better.
When you hear someone's training consisted of embodying Bruce Lee and training in the snow, I think some people would look at it as unnecessary.
When you heard the chatter, when you heard people talking, what were they saying?
Wasting my time.
When I look at Jamal Murray, man,
he doesn't have the talent.
He's just a shot maker.
We don't know what we're doing.
I just believe in this brother.
How many doubters were there?
I mean, everybody. Everybody.
Did you guys ever have a talk as a family about, you know, moving somewhere warmer where basketball was more, you know, culturally dominant?
No. So we just took a chance and believed in our, what we're doing. It wouldn't be worth it. If you don't struggle, it's not worth it. You gotta get tested.
So Roger, this is where it all started.
This is it.
But this is the court in the hill where you began to build a NBA player.
All here for hours, just working. Most of my training was creating the right habits, creating the environment in the mind to never let up.
Those days at the court start very early. It always turns into a practice. The weather's gonna be there, you just put some gloves on. It wasn't work to me.
Push-ups, dribbling on the ice, working on your balance. Some days we just go and take shots, and if you miss a shot, you gotta run hill. So you do 100 meters basically up the hill, come back down, take the shot to create that mental focus.
It's just a hoop and a ball, that's all you need.
Roger has always been tough-minded and showed a little bit of tough love to Jamal. Developing Jamal's mental strength was probably just as important as developing his basketball skills.
This all sounds very involved. It's like a Navy SEAL training course.
Yeah, but fun.
Do you remember when the hot tea came up for the first time?
I had an idea. He talked about it all the time. You know, trying to hold it together for as long as you can. Just getting through that pain.
All those unorthodox training methods that they had, a lot of them, they did it behind closed doors.
Roger channeled the ideals of his greatest inspiration and instilled them in his son.
Bruce Lee, just his, you know, his stature and the confidence, the swag he brought to, you know, his fighting. Started jumping around and, you know, get into his rhythm, his mojo. He put his love into every kick.
Murray breaks through.
Into every punch. He fought hard, but he fought with a lot of joy.
Murray again.
A lot of passion. Dedication to what he did.
Murray, the circus shot.
His dad had kind of the ingredients, but he definitely put them all together.
On any given night, that guy can light you up.
Canada is really exploding from a basketball standpoint. I thought high school is the next realistic piece. And from that, I think the stars have kind of really aligned and it's just kind of fallen into place with it being our time.
Last year, the turning point. A commitment from electrifying 6'5" guard Jamal Murray, Canada's top prospect.
How does that go in? I mean, are you kidding me, Jamal Murray?
He was at a crossroad where the prep schools with some of the stronger reputations at that point. It really came in, the Finleys, the Huntingtons. But Jamal came and made this a viable option.
That's not an easy decision to make all the time being different, right?
Yeah, I'm used to being different. Travel, get an opportunity to play against some better schools in the States and, you know, get my name out there and stuff like that. So that was one of the main reasons for me coming here.
Coach Cal's done a lot of work with like Derrick Rose and Tyreek Evans and a bunch of elite point guards. Is that a big part of why you chose Kentucky to play for a coach like that who's had experience grooming elite point guards?
Yeah, it was definitely one of the main factors. Just how he handles everybody and the team, even with last year, with all those great players on one team, you know, he just able to switch up his coaching style so quick. So, you know, he has a lot of intelligence in the game, and, you know, I trust his word and how he'll develop.
This would have been perhaps the first time an athlete announced his intentions on national television in Canada. Why did you think it was necessary, and what do you think it speaks to where basketball is?
Because I didn't attend a school in the States. You know, I stayed in Canada, stayed at my home, so I just thought it was necessary for me to wear the flag and, you know, honor my country, because it's done a lot for me, and I wouldn't be in this spot if it wasn't for them.
Talk about the pressure. I mean, obviously, you live for big games, you play big. Are you ready for the Big Blue Nation, what those fans demand down there in Kentucky, the Bluegrass State?
Of course. I mean, I've always, you know, lived up to the expectation, and I hold myself to a high expectation.
How much of a transition will it be for you making it out to the NBA three-point line?
Not much of a transition. That's kind of my range, where I like to shoot from. So I was just being consistent and adjusting my form a little bit, adjusting my strength, and how much I lift. All plays a factor.
Is there a way to work on your playmaking ability, your point guard skills? We saw a lot of that prior to Kentucky. Is that something we're going to see more of in the future as well?
Yeah, for sure. You know, a guy that can shoot it. I have the ball in his hand, create for others. You know, I'll be playing. If I'm playing the two guard, I'll be able to still show that and drive and stuff. So, just try and become a complete guard. That's what I'm trying to be, complete guard.
Welcome to the 2016 NBA Draft, which is officially starting now.
What's up, big time?
You're looking good.
Thank you. Really eager, really anxious, you know. My unknown future is about to be told, so just gonna have fun until it happens.
With the 7th pick in the 2016 NBA Draft, the Denver Nuggets select Jamal Murray from Kitchener, Canada, and the University of Kentucky.
Another player with an international background who grew up in Canada, played a year for the Wildcats.
Well, all I've got to say is,
I'm just happy to be with a great organization and, you know, part of the NBA now. It's been 19 years waiting for this moment, so it's an amazing experience. Thanks for having me, man. Thanks for choosing me. This is Jamal Murray, going to Denver. You know, shout out to, you know, my pops, my family. My thing is tight.
We'll be right back.
meditating and being calm and being in a good headspace. That's when you're at your best. But you also play really well when you're emotional and angry. How do those things go together?
I mean, when you see things clear and, you know, things go your way in the game, you know, I play with a lot of emotion. I love the game a lot. So I like to go out there and play with my heart. You know, whether the opponent likes me or not, that's not my focus. So I go out there and play my heart out, and my love for the game shows.
Yeah, what do you want your reputation to be necessarily? I mean, like, do you want to be known as the emotional leader of this team? Do you want to be a guy that plays with your heart on your sleeve?
I mean, I play with a lot of emotion, but I mean, I want to win. No, I want to be alone when it's all said and done. That, you know, I want to win every single game, no matter any situation it was, no matter who's out, no matter where we are, how I'm feeling. You know, I want to go out there and win every game I play. I'm not playing to lose, and I'm not playing just to be out there. So my teammates know that, and I try to, you know, feed off that energy and be contagious for them.
And now the shot clock at 6, into the hands of Murray, gets a screen, a three-pointer is up and in for Jamal Murray. In transition, here's Murray, little hesitation, and the reverse is good. He's been electrifying tonight, he's got 22 already. And now Murray again, presenting some challenges on the three-point line. Murray, quick release on the three. He's got it.
Jazz, when they lose, and that is turnovers, and they averaged 9.5 turnovers. When they get more than 9, they lose. Right now, that was their 10th turnover.
Both Mitchell and Murray is off the charts right now. Step back three on the way, and he's got another one. Jamal Murray. A minute to go. Denver using some clock here. Jokic finding Murray. Murray, does he got another one in him? Oh, you bet he does! And that might be the dagger! Wow!
Wow! Oh, man, two 50-point games in this series.
Check out his last three quarters, 21, 16, and 21. Those are quarters in the fourth, Jerry Greenberg. You got a star on your hands.
Certainly do. Jamal Murray, your coach told us before the game that this week has been an emotional roller coaster. How did you carry over the momentum from an explosive game 4, game 5, and then put everything else aside that happened this week and go out and drop 50 in a must-win game tonight?
You got a way to win. These shoes mean a lot. With all the shoes mean a lot.
Take a deep breath, Jamal. You were outstanding tonight. We understand that these are tough times. Jamal, what are you thinking about right now?
I just want to win. And in life, you find things that hold value, and things to fight for. We found something worth fighting for as an NBA, as a collective unit. And I usually choose as a symbol to me to keep fighting all around the world. So like I said, they give me a lot of power to keep fighting. We want to win. I show my emotion. It comes out, so.
Between that.
Look, you guys both look gassed, both sides, and the Clippers we know is going to be a rugged test. Between now and Thursday, what do?
We play Thursday?
Yeah.
You don't get 2 days off?
No. No, it's Thursday.
Man, well, that's a bummer. No, like I said, we just got to move ahead. We got a different mentality. You know, it was a tough first round series. You know, we had to get it the hard way, go all seven games. Now we got to switch our focus to, you know, back to game one, back to the start. And that's the mental grind, not just playoffs, but back in the bubble. You know, whoever packed their bags, unpacked their bags. You know, whoever wasn't a believer in the Nuggets down 3-1, we're still here. And we got a big task, you know, on Thursday against the Clippers. So, such a mentality. Let's go get another series.
All right. Sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but yeah, you got a game in a couple days. Get some rest, man. Congratulations on a really exceptionally exciting series. Best of the playoffs thus far, Jamal. Congratulations, man. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thank you, guys.